Hello, today I'm going to tell you why I bought a big house and why you should too. I'm also going to give you a tour of my house. So let's go ahead and hop in here. This house, we bought it almost a year ago. It's 3,500 square feet. And in Indiana, this house costs about $500,000. I live in Indiana. In other parts of the United States, it's probably $700, $800, or even more, depending on where you're at. This is the front library that we have here. It was an office until our business got a physical office. So now it's just kind of a sitting room, a sitting area. Okay, let's keep going in here. What I really love about this house, we bought this house, it was brand new, so nobody else has lived in this house except for us. The thing that I like about it is that it is wide open. Houses that are built today, they want it wide open. You have the living room that bleeds into the kitchen here, and then we also have a sunroom that's built back there. Not every house in this neighborhood has the sunroom. We were lucky enough that this one was available for us to purchase. But why did I buy this big house? Well, number one, this house is very big for us because we don't have any kids, but it is well below our means of what we could really rationally afford. I think they say you should have a mortgage of about 20 to 30, maybe even 50% of your income. This is way below our means. So we bought a big house because, in my opinion, real estate will continue to go up. And in 5 years to 10 years, when we want to sell this house, it'll probably go up around 20%. So 20% on a $500,000 house is more than 20% on a $300,000 house. So if you can afford a house and it's below your means, you should probably buy the house that you're going to be able to resell for the highest value. You're also going to have the biggest return. So the bigger the house, the more expensive it is, the more that it's going to go up. So families are always looking for houses like this. So it really made sense for us to do it. So what I'm trying to tell you today is buy a house that you can afford, but buy the biggest house and most resale value house that you can. Okay, let's go into here. We also have the Christmas village set up, just a little Christmas time here. We're also under construction. We are building built-ins for the fireplace to put bookshelves up there to help the resale. All this is about is resale. On this side of the house, we have the guest bathroom without a shower. And then here we have a downstairs bedroom. This is a 5-bedroom house. There's 4 bedrooms upstairs. Each bedroom has a bathroom. So there's 5 to 6 bathrooms in this house, I believe. So let's go in here. This is the home gym. This used to be my home office. We turned it into a home gym because now we have an office and we have an extra bedroom. So I come in here and I work out. We do go to a gym. We go to F45. But this is just a home gym. If it's really cold out or I just don't feel like going to the gym, I can come in here and get after it. So really like the home gym, and I would suggest that the easiest that you can make it possible for you to work out, you should do it that way. And this is Indie Bug. Indiana Jones. So what I'm trying to tell you today is real estate will go up because they're not making more of it, okay? So buy a house that you can afford, but buy a house that is affordable. I'm not gonna give you the tour of the upstairs because it's more personal up there. But if you like this type of content, I post content about business, money, how to buy businesses. And the reason I was able to afford this house at a very young age is because I started a business and the business has grown and it's been successful. So my question for you is, are you going to find a business to buy? Are you going to find a business to start? Because that's how you're going to get to the next level in your life from a wealth creation perspective.